I'm Marilena. I come from a small, tiny, little, magical country called Guatemala, which is located in the middle of the Americas, border to Mexico. And we can talk a lot about it later, but today I'm going to spend some minutes with you talking about change. And I think that's very important for me to clarify, because what we are going to present to you right now is not finished by any means. It's just getting started. In fact, it is a pilot project of an idea that, as Michael mentioned, we are putting together. And I am sure that Monday morning it probably changed. So keep in mind that this is an evolution project. This project will evolve, hopefully for the better. But to give you a little bit of background and what's happening and how things in life, the only constant is change. This was me 2 years ago. You see over here? and in my prior life, I call it my prior life, my prior job. I've been involved with beverages all my life, starting when I was 17 years old, back home in Guatemala with the local Pepsi bottler. I worked with them for 10 years in many capacities, mostly marketing and sales. So I was playing with bottles when I was little, bottles and cases. Then I moved to PepsiCo. I worked in the soft drink business for 10 years. I love Pepsi. I still drink Pepsi, and I hope many people will do it too. I worked with Pepsi for 10 years, again, in marketing and sales capacities. And then I moved to another project that we did with Unilever, and I worked with Lipton, the iced tea. I was in charge of the business of Lipton in Latin America, from Mexico to Chile, very big business back then. But as you can imagine, as much fun as it was, it lasted 20 years, and I needed to get down on that roller coaster. And 2 years ago, again, the winds of change came, and I decided to open my own little shop. I've been working in my, what I call my study, my studio, which is a marketing and business development consultancy firm, basically with the idea of helping Latin American companies that wanted to come to the US, or US companies that wanted to come to Latin America. And that's what I've been doing. A couple of very fun projects. Some brands from Jamaica. Then I started working also with alcohol, because it's also another passion of mine. And then also with the idea of my studio, the idea was to do two of the things I want more. One is marketing, and the other is the Maya culture, which is really my true passion and my ancestral heritage. So I try to do a little bit of work also with helping promote the Maya culture around the world. So with that came a project that is the genesis of what I'm going to be talking to you today. Guti, as we call it in Ecuador, it's a beautiful volcanic water that comes from exactly the center of the earth, infused with a very, very, very special size of bubble and a taste of the volcanic agricultural surroundings where it comes from. So we think it's a very well established business in Ecuador. Just to give you a little bit of dimensions, it's around 13 million cases. It's around $30 million business. So it's a pretty decent brand. It's the icon of Ecuador. We have 93% of the share of market. We have all the sizes, since 3 liters to little ones. It's a very well-developed category in Ecuador. But the company that we represent distributes not only in one country, they have a footprint in 16 countries all across the Americas. They are brewers, they are soft drinks, they do juices, they do a lot of things. So we came with the idea of, okay, what can we do with this marvelous land? Can we take it out of the equatorial border? Is there a possibility? And that's how we started working with Michael, trying to put together a project to start exporting wheat. As I imagine many of you guys have in your plants. We tried. We tried for 2.5 years. We lost a little bit of money in doing so. We were able to do inroads in a couple of countries. When we put money behind the ground, it sold a little. When we took it, it didn't sell anymore. We brought it to the US. We went with our natural distributor. We were able to put it in some cash and carry stores with the Equatorial Community League, which is not the strategy that we wanted for this brand. So we were struggling and struggling. We tried to go knock the doors of the big distributors. That's kind of what we used to do. It was very tough. The big guys don't talk to you because you're too little. The little guys, you better do it yourself. So that's where we were trapped in a conundrum. What do we do? We have a wonderful product. We have resources to support it, but we don't want to waste it. What's the biggest barrier we have? Guys, there's no go-to-market. The big companies don't know how to incubate brands. What do we do? So that is why, and that is how this idea of Waters of the World came to mind. Basically on the principle of, if there's not an idea go-to-market, let's build it. Let's build a company, let's build a company that is devoted to smaller brands that really can put the focus that they deserve and that they need to be sold and also to create the category. When you know what, when you create a category, it's uphill. And people don't like that. People like big things very fast. So we decided, let's go and build this idea of the go-to-market. As we are kind of a big corporation, we wanted to be sure. We didn't want it. We had wasted 2 years and resources in launching things and then failing. So we decided to go a little bit slower and launch a pilot project in the most difficult place in the world. In fact, Michael told us we were absolutely crazy, but we decided to do it in New York. Mostly because we like big challenges. I've been living there for the last 10 years and I love it. And because, as they say, if you can make it there, you'll make it anywhere. So that's how this idea started. What we did is, okay guys, let's kind of forget about Wheaties for a little bit as a brand, and let's focus our energy in this new project called Waters of the World, of which Wheaties will be a wheel, but will not be the whole. This, as I'm telling you, will probably change, but the idea is our product is the water menu, as we've all been discussing and talking this morning. What is going to be different, or the thing that we want to do really different, is three places. The first one, we want to be the kings of e-commerce. We really want to bet high in creating a top-of-the-line platform, as Michael was comparing it to Uber, that can help us achieve scale to e-commerce. We are focusing right now in the Horeca segment, but we don't see it as a source of profitability. We see it as an advertisement. And basically that's our strategy. And the third one, not now. In fact, I don't let my people call retailers yet. Right now they can only do two things, e-commerce and restaurants or Horecas. But the third play will be, of course, in the future, high retail. Since we wanted to do this project, we started calling a couple of friends. Look with Michael for the best waters we could find in New York. And in fact, we are working with Deb, we are working with Philippe, We are working with Pedras from Portugal, of course, on water. And we brought the two seasoned waters, Valverde and Brown. And we started putting this portfolio in front of customers and in front of consumers and see what happens. Let's see if they understand, like, and if this idea can get any traction before we start investing the big bucks behind it. So this is our pilot. As you see, stage one is New York. Of course, once we feel comfortable with this toy, we will expand it to the other key cities in the US and then to the rest of countries in Latin America where it makes sense. Right now, we are focusing on three neighborhoods, the hot neighborhoods of New York, Chelsea, Soho, and Hell's Kitchen. We started with, we structured the pilot in three stages. The first one was an event called Apole, in which you will see that there's Dev, I think there's Philippe too. But this is a Burgundy wine festival that we sponsored and that we use as a pop-up kind of experiment to put the idea of the variety, the portfolio, and we did a tasting for around 300 sommeliers of New York. Very interesting experience. The big learnings there was the sommeliers understand the idea that the water is like wine. There was no rejection, there was signs of adoption. And we started playing, we took it on the road. The second event was influencers tasting session that we just conducted in New York last month, and of which I'm gonna show you a little bit. There's my pavilion.
Sorry.
There we go.
Thank you.
very interesting activity, not only because it was a really fun dinner with great food and great water, but also because we really put attention in the casting. We wanted to get opinions of people that we consider were influencers and have a say, and could help us drive the project and the category ahead. That's not mine. And that's it. Thank you. Okay. As Michael was telling you, one of the key elements was that we were able to have Elizabeth Walker, who is a three-time winner Iron Chef. She was like a great, great asset in the meeting. She really understood the idea of water as a special ingredient. She is also pioneering this trend of healthy eating doesn't need to be boring, and it can be as tasteful and as interesting as any other dining experience. So Elizabeth gave us a lot of insight on how it is imperative that we bring the chef on board with the idea, because really they are really looking for special waters, special ingredients, creativity to bring to their menus.
So what is the
restaurateur? What does it mean? The restaurateur is sitting down there, Mr. Philippe Legerme. Philippe was in the activity also, and Philippe has given us also very interesting perspectives looking at the project from a restaurant owner's eyes. So we're seeing the project from how does a restaurant owner sees it, how a chef sees it. We also have there two bloggers, one is Renato, who has, I think, 70,000 followers in his social media. So we were trying to really bring up high opinion people, put the concept to the acid test, and from a pool perspective, I can tell you, as Michael was saying, that there is pool for this project. I think the big challenge, honestly, relies on the push side. And I think it's a logistics and it's a sales capability discussion. I think from a pool side, this project will flow. From the push side is where we really need to be the muscle, and if this thing fails, it's gonna be because of the go-to-market capacity. Where are we now? We know that consumers like the idea of a water portfolio. Michael told us, Martin showed us, the concept from a pool perspective seems to be proved. Obviously, we are here to build a business, and honestly, we want to build a very big business. Otherwise, it doesn't make sense. So we will only be as good as the portfolio we can build, and that is one of the reasons that we really believe that this idea that Michael mentioned in the morning of let's come together makes absolute sense. I had the pleasure of working with the board of the Colombia Coffee Association, working in a project called Juan Valdez. Juan Valdez is basically this. It's a variety of the most sophisticated coffee growers of Colombia that were trying to sell their coffees in the world for 25 years. No way. Everybody was fighting, everybody lost money. The only way they were able to do it is by getting together in a cooperative mindset, putting all the resources together and trying to fight the big guys. So I really believe that if we find a way to come together as small producers, as small brands, as small artisanal water companies, we get more chance of building something that is scalable. So if you guys don't have a distribution in the Americas, give me a call, maybe we can do some business together in the future. But as I was mentioning, this is basically a project that is changing, a project that is evolving. Right now it's just a pilot. We are in the process of building the portfolio. We are in the process of building the team. We started building our e-commerce capability, which is going to take time and is something that we really want to invest behind. The idea is, if everything works as we have planned, to be launching live in New York and in the West Coast by this year. We are preparing the grounds and we are preparing the project, but we wanted to come and share it with you as family, even though it's not ready. And hopefully it can be enriched with your brands, with your ideas, and with your time. Thank you very much.